friends, so in the previous video we have discussed verbally the process of acquisition of books in Indian scenario, or how do we purchase the item in the library. Now we are going to see the same thing in Koha, that how we have to process in Koha. So first we have to go to acquisition, and then here we need to search. For example, I search Bikas publication, and if it is there, okay. If it is not there, so first we need to create the vendor name. So I enter Bikas publication, and then I come down. I can add all the detail, the vendor address, publisher address, everything, and then here I give. Suppose I know that in all books I am going to get discount of 20%, so I can fix the 20% discount. But if I am not sure, I can leave this. I need 30 days. Within 30 days, I should get the book, and then I can save here. So I have added one vendor here. Likewise, when we finalize the empanelment of vendor, in the beginning itself we can do everything, means adding the vendor, so that we will not have to add one by one. So I assume that we have already done this. So now let us go back again to acquisition module and search the same vendor which we have added just now, and let us see what it shows. Now you can see that earlier it was coming no records found. Now it is showing Bikas publication is available. So as per our discussion, first we searched the vendor, it was not there, we added. Now we are going to create the basket. Basket means purchase order. So I click on new basket, and basket name or purchase order we can give manually Bikas 01, and the same thing for easy maintenance, we can add or maintain one register where we can add the purchase number. So what will happen, we will be remembering, or it will be in our record, that next time when we generate the purchase order, we will not forget that what was the last order for this vendor. So it will be easy for us to maintain. And then if you want any, give any internal note for this vendor, you can give, or for the staff. And if you want any internal note for vendor, you can add here. And then create item when receiving an item. This is very, very important, because when do we receive the order, that is the most important thing, and when we have to create the item. When we add the bibliographical detail, we have two options. The first one, we add the bibliographical detail, and the second page we add the item where we add the accession number. So generally we do not receive order, or we do not create item when we place order, because we do not know the accession number, what accession number going to be. Or when we place order, that time also we are not sure. So the best thing is that when we receive item, we have option that we can write the accession number on the invoice, as well as we can write the accession number in the register, and in the software also we can record. So the best time to create item when we receive an order after placing the purchase order. So I am keeping the default value and then save it. So we have successfully created the purchase order, or you can say the basket. Now let us go and see what is our next, add the title. So after creating the purchase order, add the title to PO. So just click on this, and as we discussed in the previous video, that there are many methods through which we can add the title to purchase order. So I am taking the new record, and I can see that the text box is ready now to receive the entry. So theory of library management, this is my title. am giving Ranganathan, comma SR, publisher Vikas Publication. This is simply I am assuming and giving the detail. 1970 ISBN I can give or leave it. Second, how many copies I am going to receive, or I have to send the purchase order. And here I need to select the fund, from which fund the item will be purchased. Currency, default currency will be INR. Vendor price, what will be the price of vendor price? This is the tentative price which we need to change when we receive the invoice. And by default, you can see here the 20% discount is there. So it has automatically calculated the total value, and then click on save button. So this is the option, means we filled all the options and we have added the record to this purchase order, because 01. And now our next task is that we can download the CSV file, or we can send the email order to the vendor, or we can print in our format, and after printing we can send the PO and then close the basket. So we can see here that our first step, send the PO to vendor and close the basket, is over here. So the first step is over. So we have discussed in this video that how we can create the basket, how we can create the vendor, and how we can add the title to the purchase order, and how we can send the purchase order and close the PO. Next video we are going to discuss about the second step.